Spider-Man No Way Home terus memecahkan rekor dan ekspektasi analis dalam pemasukan box office, baik di Amerika Serikat maupun dunia. Pengamat perfilman menilai banyak faktor berada di balik sukses film ini.
You don't pull in $260 million in an opening weekend and it's just kids. It's just no way. I think everybody came out for it. People were sick of being home.
People were going with the expectation that this is going to be a great experience to see on a big screen with the big surround sound coming at. You expect the production quality to be good, you expect the acting to be good.
Menurut Richard Craig, daya tarik Spider-Man juga bersifat multi-generasi.
A lot of people like myself grew up on Spider-Man. Now you have new generations that are grabbing. My son is a Spider-Man fan. Like I said, you've had three recent adaptations of Spider-Man. So it crosses a lot of different lines in terms of who we are as people.
Pengamat perfilman Insider.com mencatat 3 film tersukses setahun terakhir, semuanya merupakan film komik Marvel.
Is this what you wanted?
Selain Spider-Man, ada Shang-Chi and The Legend of the Ten Rings, lalu Venom Let There Be Carnage. Selain sama-sama menampilkan tokoh Marvel, satu lagi kesamaan antara ketiga film sukses ini adalah ketiganya diluncurkan secara eksklusif lewat bioskop. Studio lain menempuh jalur berbeda, yaitu meluncurkan secara bersamaan atau berdekatan di bioskop dan juga di layanan streaming masing-masing. Warner Brothers misalnya meluncurkan filmnya bersamaan di bioskop dan juga layanan streaming HBO Max. The Matrix Resurrections misalnya, juga film fiksi ilmiah lainnya Dune. Sutradara Dune menyalahkan relatif rendahnya pemasukan Dune karena keputusan Warner Brothers merilis bersamaan lewat streaming. Tapi Angela Watercutter dari jurnal Wired.com nilai bahwa susah menelaah pemasukan film dari layanan streaming karena belum jelas berapa yang menonton secara legal atau mengunduh secara ilegal lewat torrent.
Even after COVID, does it make more sense for them to funnel us into theaters and force us to, only have access to these films for 7 to 8 weeks in these particular spots? Or is it more profitable for them to allow us to watch it at our leisure, whether that be through subscription or some sort of advertising profit market mechanism that they create?
Seperti banyak kebiasaan era pandemi, menonton film baru dari rumah bisa berlanjut bahkan selepas pandemi. Dan produsen film pun harus menyesuaikan. Dari Washington DC, Nova Purwadi dan tim VOA.